Point number one, all plates will be in line. Point number two, contact. Point number three,
all plates will be integrated together.
Point number four, rotation.
Clutch is a mechanical device which engages and disengages from the power transmission shaft to the driven shaft in any machine.
Let us see how the power is transmitted from the crankshaft to the clutch, to the gearbox and to the rear wheel.
For smooth engaging and disengaging of gears, we must apply the clutch. What actually happening in the clutch? It is very simple. This is called pressure plate. Why? Because the pressure will be applied on this plate from the clutch lever through the cable, will be fitted here like this. So when the clutch is applied, this portion touches this portion, there will be a point like this, and here also this is the point where the pressure is applied on this point. When you apply the clutch, the plates will get separated like this, not this much, a little bit from here to here. It actually getting compressed, and how the plates are becoming loose. If you watch it particularly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 grooves are there, and in the clutch bell also there are 5 grooves provided, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So on the clutch bell there will be 5 springs grooves provided in the pressure plate. So this will sit like this exactly, get compressed and making the all clutch plates to become loose like this. Now the clutch is applied, that's why the plates has become loose. When I release it, when I release the clutch, it becomes integrated, the whole unit becomes one. This is called clutch bell. If you closely monitor, there are cuts provided here. Those cuts are for the purpose of locking the lock plate. The lock plate goes up to here and it will be locked with the locking ring. Now let us see the difference between lock plate and the separating plate. If you put it, it will go inside, it will come out. Whereas if you put the locking ring, it goes up to here and it will be locked with the locking ring. That is the difference between a locking plate and a separating plate. The movement starts with lock plate. The lock plate holds all clutch plates to become one unit. That means the whole clutch unit will be integrated. The magic of movement. The movement starts with the stopper plate. Why? Because it is stopping all clutch plates. When we release the clutch, making the whole clutch unit as one unit to engage. In this unit, a starting plate will be the clutch plate. The separating plate separates two clutch plates. So that means the separating plate will come in between two clutch plates. The separating plates have cuts. These cuts will sit into the cuts of the clutch bell. When the clutch bell rotates, when the unit rotates, the separating plate also moves along with the unit, giving grip to the all clutch plates. There are cuts provided here. There are projecting parts provided on the clutch plates. The clutch bell will be connected to the gear drive. When the rotation starts, the clutch bell moves like this. On this unit, the pressure plate will be fitted. In between, there will be 5 springs. At first, clutch plate, separating plate, again clutch plate, again separating plate, again clutch plate, again separating plate, again clutch plate, at last, locking plate. All the unit from here to here will be locked with the locking ring. When we release the clutch, the pressure on the pressure plate will be released. It will come to the original position against the spring tension. When it comes to the original position, all clutch plates will be integrated.
I will show you from two directions. One is from the crankshaft side and one is from the wheel side. Assume the engine is in on position. From the wheel drive, it is moving up to here. And if you watch from this direction, from the crankshaft direction, it is moving up to here. Why? Because there is no integrity between the clutch plates. Clutch plates has become separated, making the drive to disengage. Now the vehicle is moving. Now we are moving it. When you release the clutch, it started moving. So this is the thing which is happening in the clutch.
Once again, I will show you how the whole system is getting engaged when the clutch is released. Clutch applied, gear applied, but I did not release the clutch. Watch the movement now. The moment I release the clutch, the whole unit will become one unit by connecting both of them. That means from the power transmission shaft to the wheel shaft. That's all, friends. I hope it is useful. Let us meet again.